I'd like to actually encourage you to do that. Maybe even shut your eyes. I know we have all these devices, and that's really there to help you visually. But remember that we're here to hear a beautiful organ concert, so you can just kind of shut your eyes and listen to the beautiful music as well. I don't feel like you have to be watching the TV. So these next couple pieces, we have a really excellent composer that's maybe not heard as much. Sir George Thomas Alden Ball is a very, well, obviously acclimated being a Sir British composer. So we have, again, these softer kind of diapasons and the flutes on the organ. And then we have our very own Dr. Ellen Jacobson, who composed a beautiful piece on the chorale, Come Down, O Love Divine, followed by some jazz rock. Enjoy. It's getting a lot of memories playing some of those pieces because they're some of the ones that I played here and over at the Methodist Church. Across the way, I used to play two services there and then run over between and play in the summer here. So it was kind of a sprint race, but maybe the priests and pastors didn't even know what was going on. Anyway, I probably might have played that one better then than I do now, but sometimes it takes a little more gumption to play something you played a long time ago than to learn something new. So these next set, again, I think you're hearing a theme here. They're going to be softer again. Thank heavens, maybe. So we return to across the lake again. I guess we were in Germany there, but now we're going to France to hear one of the great, great, great pieces of French repertoire. So we hear the French oboe in solo with beautiful flutes. And the French style is adding a lot of reeds, the brass instruments, and the reed instruments to the organ. So you'll listen for that. And we have another prelude and fugue, as it says in the program, and then a variation on that at the end with beautiful flutes. Thank you. as it says in the program, we operate a Civilly Institute. And what that is a missionary outreach in sacred music for missionary priests, missionary religious sisters. And really, I'm sure Father Victor could give a great homily on this. We are all missionaries, right? And I've had actually missionaries from South America say that Americans are actually more of a missionary land than even South America. Because here you have to, you can't just walk from house to house and see who your parishioners are. And you have to figure out who they are and who goes to what church. And then obviously, as we know in South Dakota, we drive quite a while to get to our churches. So in some ways, maybe we're more missionary than we used to be. So these pieces, Domenico Civilly, as it says in the program, he wanted, with all his heart, to become a Jesuit priest. So he left fame and riches of the organist world. I don't know about fame and riches, but he was very, very talented, very famous in Rome. He had a very prestigious position, but he left all that. He went to South America, to the jungles. I don't know if you've seen the movie The Mission. In the 1980s, Robert De Niro, it's a great movie. You hear some of the same music here, and they really modeled it after some of these beautiful Spanish and Italian composers, Domenico Civilly. So you'll hear beautiful elevation and some toccata.
Thank you.
famous and very full French pieces. So there's not a whole lot I can say other than to, again, maybe close your eyes and hear all the similarities together. I put a little joke in the end of the second piece that sometimes we hear the organ is too loud. And so this is one way that the organ can be joyously loud. And these pieces aren't necessarily meant for mass, but we can hear what the organ can really do in a beautiful Easter Sunday. Think about our still in the season of Easter. So enjoy these two French pieces, and I believe we'll have a way to thank everyone between them. And personally, I do want to thank, before the end, especially John Nordlie, who I don't believe was able to be here with us, but John Nordlie, Eric Gray, Jill Brown, John's brother Paul, and all the crew, they've been good friends to me, but I know how much heart and soul and sweat and time goes into this project. It's a lot. I know Jeff can tell you that as the beautiful janitor. There's so much that goes into it, and it's not just a quick project, but it will last for many, many, many years, hopefully to generations and generations. I also